डिफरेंस बिफोर एंड आफ्टर।
ठीक
एनी डिफरेंस बिफोर द ब्रेक एंड आफ्टर द ब्रेक, प्लीज रेस्पॉन्ड।
सर बैठे बैठे जो जॉब हम करते हैं लोग, तो थोड़ा घूमना चाहिए बीच में। तो आई कंप्लीटेड ऑलमोस्ट 500 स्टेप्स, सो दैट
वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड।
हाँ
सो व्हाट डिड यू गेट आउट ऑफ इट?
नाउ फीलिंग वेरी कंफर्टेबल,
वेरी गुड, फीलिंग कंफर्टेबल। आई नेक्स्ट,
एनर्जेटिक एंड
यू
एंथुजियास्टिक।
हैव आंसर्ड, एंथुजियास्टिक, फाइन। नेक्स्ट,
यस
एनी अदर कमेंट?
मोटिवेटेड, मोर मोटिवेटेड नाउ, रेडी
मोर
टू अटेंड फॉर द
मोटिवेटेड?
नेक्स्ट। यस,
नहीं,
आपको
ओके।
सर ईगर टू
एनी अदर कमेंट?
सर वेटिंग फॉर योर नेक्स्ट सेशन, एक्चुअली ईगर टू हियर यू,
रफुल्ला जी,
ईगर टू हियर यू सर, ईगर टू हियर यू व्हाट नेक्स्ट, व्हाट
थोड़ा
नेक्स्ट,
थोड़ा वॉल्यूम 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 इंक्रीज द वॉल्यूम फ्रॉम योर साइड।
ईगर टू हियर यू व्हाट इज नेक्स्ट नाउ, दैट इज व्हाट।
ओके ओके, दैट्स फाइन, दैट्स फाइन। एनी अदर फील दैट यू गॉट बिफोर एंड आफ्टर द ब्रेक? Only one person said comfortable, one person said more motivated. Any other? Type किया या नहीं आप लोग, ये बता मेरे को।
सर एक्साइटेड हुए कि और क्या सर बताने वाले नया हमारे बारे
एक्साइटेड है? नहीं, अपने आपके अंदर में चाय पीने के बाद कुछ फील नहीं हुआ क्या? Did you not get activated? Did you get? Did you not get reactivated? Did you not get re-energized?
Yes, sir.
Definitely.
Yes, sir. बताने के बाद आप यस सर यस सर करके बोल रहे हैं। आप बोलने, I was expecting that word from you. That regeneration is very important.
Yeah.
You have to take breaks to get regenerate yourself. Not only in your academic life, but also in your personal life. मेरे को मालूम है आप सब लोग वीकेंड पे बाहर जाके लंच करते या डिनर करते फैमिली के साथ। I have all the statistics about you. Then you feel that you need a break and you want to have a change. ये सब किस वजह से जाते आप? ये नहीं है खाने के लिए नहीं। That gives some kind of a refreshness. That gives you some regeneration. Family outings also needed. Please, I am not finding fault. Please, they are need. Only thing is, don't go every day out. That's the only thing. Similarly, you should have such breaks in your academic life. You also should go out from your routines and learn something. Once a year. Or twice a year, go out and attend a seminar, attend a conference, attend a workshop, meet some new academic shields. That interaction will regenerate you. That interaction will give you more energy. That is the purpose why this kind of training programs are arranged, are being conducted. Not for certificate, APIs, your what do you call CAS. They are only just to encourage as a reward. But the basic philosophy is this. So make it a point that you all go out. Don't say that mera family bada hai, mummy papa hai, in-laws hain, bacche hain, sabke saath rahe. Everybody will have this problem. If not this problem, some other problem. In spite of that, you should do that. Make sure don't go and say that Hyderabad se koi bala isliye I am going out karke, don't go and complain and tell in your family, they will curse me, ye kon hai bolne wala karke. Don't take my name. Okay, right. Hello, are you back?
Yes,
yes sir, yes,
yes, yes
no
sir.
Response.
Yes sir, yes sir, yes sir.
When I ask, then only you are responding. अपने आप क्यों नहीं बोलते हैं?
सर इंस्ट्रक्शन है हमको वैसे.
पार्डन पार्डन
इंस्ट्रक्शन है ना, बीच बीच में मतलब म्यूट ही होना है, अनम्यूट नहीं होना है.
अनम्यूट होके बात करो करके मैंने पहले बताया, दैट वाज द फर्स्ट एग्रीमेंट बिटवीन यू एंड मी. यू मींस पार्टिसिपेंट्स, दैट वी विल हैव अ परफेक्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ अनम्यूटिंग योरसेल्फ एज एंड व्हेन यू लाइक. इसी टाइम पे व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू स्पीक यू कैन स्पीक विद मी. That is the purpose of taking breaks, just get regenerated, get re-energized and refreshed, right? So I think you are enough refreshed with this. Any questions till now that you have on topic that I have presented to you?
No. No, everything is clear. Means you make it very much clear through interactive sessions.
सर नमस्ते.
नमस्ते
सर, आपने जो क्वालिटीज विशेषताओं की बात की, पर निजी जिंदगी में जब अनुभव आते हैं, जो अध्यापक जिन्हें हम कहते हैं, वे इम्पार्शियल ना होने से विद्यार्थियों को काफी दिक्कत होती है, जिसे हम निष्पक्षता कहते हैं. तो हम चाहेंगे कि एक अध्यापक में वो भेदभाव की दृष्टि ना हो, समानता का बोध हो, ये हम अपेक्षा करते हैं आज.
Yeah, that is true. That is true. That comes with your culture. You have culture to treat all the students equally. You will not have any partiality over the first benchers or last benchers. You will not have partiality between urban and rural area people. You will not have partiality over white skinned and black skinned. ये नहीं है. So they are all equal. So it is a part of your culture. That is very important. You should not discriminate students in your class. So with these skills on top of the domain knowledge and the qualities, you will become a level 2 teacher. Now you will not be happy, I know that. You want to be a great teacher, a professional teacher, where people will remember you forever as an eternal teacher, even after you are leaving the job or leaving the planet Earth also, people should remember. Are you not remembering one or two such great teachers in your life?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, yes, sir, we do.
You are not remembering all the teachers who taught you right from class 1 to PhD. But you remember 5 or 6 good names.
Yes, sir. Only
yes, sir.
3 to 5, not more than that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Why that number is only 3 to 5, not 30, 40?
Because these are the people who make an impact in our life.
We find that quality, 8 quality in them that you explained in the beginning. Those qualities we found in them, so that's the reason I think we remember only few teachers.
Okay, or any other comment?
So teachers are not teachers for us, sir. They are educators for us. So likewise, some of the information, in spite of regular teaching they are giving to us, they are valuable for in our personal life and professional life also. So we remember some of our teachers till now, sir.
You are lucky who have guided you even in your personal life. That's a
yes,
great
sir.
Thing. Yeah, great thing. Only some teachers.
Sir, one thing I would like to express is there are basically two types of the people who come across us. And as a student, we were actually choosing some of the teacher as a good one and some of the teacher as not to that extent. And we remember both. Now, sometimes we enjoy talking about those teachers who were very strict and who were not actually that much. Sometimes they were not that good. We didn't like them because they used to punish us, or we never used to get what they are teaching is. Good so months. In both ways, good teacher also and bad teacher also. Mm. So we remember both of them.
Yeah, you should remember both of them. You should remember for good teachers to be good. You should remember bad teachers not to be so. Is yes. it that?
So that I do learning. Not only see that the world which is fancy.
That is also a great learning.
Yes. And out of that, we can actually, being in the same field, now we can choose what we want to be, how we want people to remember us, whether we to be remembered as a good one or we to be remembered as a cruel one.
Yes, true. You are right. Now, I wish, sincere wish is that you all should be remembered by your students like those two or three teachers. Aapne kaha na? Nahi sir, sare party logon ko yaad nahi hai, only two or three, five or six karke. I want you to be in that small group of two or three to your students. Don't you want to be?
Sir, may I?
We'll try, sir.
Yes, Deepali.
Sir, with your permission. Sir, on the contrary, I was thinking of my students during the break. Was I successful in whatever you have just briefed us in detail, you have explained. Were we successful enough in educating our students in that manner? I was pondering on this, sir. During the break.
No, that's
it was
good.
The students I was thinking of, not teachers, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Sorry. Pardon? Repeat.
On the contrary, as I said, I wasn't thinking of my teachers, but I was thinking of my students, sir.
Good. That's also good. You think of your students also sometimes. It is not wrong. What I want to say is when you are thinking about students means you are more conscious. You are more conscious and you will be conscious to be an educator from tomorrow onwards.
Yes, sir.
Now, so that the students should never feel bad about you, never belittle you, never miss your class.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that being conscious about students is a greater quality. I will speak about that little later.
Yes.
Ahead of me, in fact.
I have an observation with me, actually.
Yeah, please.
I'm a law faculty. And we used to have two courses, sir. One 5 years course and one 3 years course. So in 3 years, mostly the working people are doing law. So all of them may not be a 24-hour student. But some of the student, those they were not regular in class. They used to go to their office, and only sometimes they used to get an occasion to talk with me and to get the concept clear. And to that extent, I helped them a lot. They remember me till date. And even though I was not having a very regular interaction with them, some of them, I may not be even seeing them. Some of them may not be even seeing me, that who is Anita ma'am. But still they remember me, and they tell, even in their profession, if they somewhat get a difficulty, they make me a call. They ask me what to do, what not to do. So far as legal aspect is concerned. So I feel myself to be like, okay, I've reached out my student. Though physically they may not be there in my class, but to some extent, I've reached out my students, and that is what I found me to be a successful to that extent. So at least 10% of good teacher.
What is the reason for that?
The reason is that I have understood what the need is, and I found myself to be always acquainted with what my quality as a teacher is. And whenever my student is coming with a doubt, I am there available to him to answer him.
Knowingly or unknowingly, you have guided them properly.
Yes.
And build some confidence in them.
Yes.
Jo abhi aapne maine bataya na, capacity and courage. You have created that capacity in their minds.
And also developed
a trust on you. They have a trust on you now.
Yes.
And then they will call. अब मैडम अनिता जी को बात किया तो ये सॉल्व हो जाता है करके They will ask you question without any hesitation.
Yes. And they even do not even feel ki, yani to know who is Anita ma'am, but they knew ki haan, agar Anita ma'am ko call kiya to iska solution milega. So
aapne brand even, you have built a brand for Anita.
Yes.
Is not a person now. Anita is a teacher from ABC Institute. Anita is a teacher who can help, who can guide, who can motivate, who can solve the problem, or who can advise us. That's a brand you have already created. That is what I was talking to you, all the people. You create a brand for yourself. With seeing, without seeing, or in spite of you. They should
Some
know
of the students who were actually the typewriters and they were the typists in the courts, they were the readers in the course. Some of them were like assisting the judges, but simultaneously they were doing their law. Some of I taught even the manager of MOIL day and night during their exam time, because they never used to come to college, they never used to come for any of attending the lectures or something like that. But at the time of examination, they used to rush to me saying that, madam, please, can you help us out? Can you please explain the concept? So day and night I have spent for them without charging anything, just for the sake, because they are my student and they want to prosper. They want to go in heights. So far as their career is concerned, I have given that much time. And that is the actually treasure which I feel that it is with me, that my students are achieving success. That is what in them I found my success to be.
Good. Good. I will give you a big clap.
Thank you, sir. Keep it up.
Yeah, thank you. Keep it up. Now, I would like to see all of you as great teachers or the best teachers. I will call simply as professional teachers. Like Anita ji, you should always be a professional teacher, for which you should now develop some competencies. Qualities forget, skills forget. Now we will go to competence. There is a nice article available on the web called Professional Competencies of a Teacher, written by a Turkish author. If you want, note down, I will repeat. The Professional Competencies of a Teacher, written by Selvi, S-E-L-V-I. It is available on the web. Go to Google and type, you will get this article. Read this. He has mentioned about 9 such competencies. Wonderful. I have picked up 3 or 4, and I would like to share with my experience, and I want to add something here, that how you will become a professional teacher. The moment you develop these competencies, which I am going to present, for you will definitely become a great teacher, and your students will remember forever. It includes 2 main abilities. The first one related to teacher's own lifelong learning ability. Teacher's own lifelong learning ability. You have to learn. You have to be on your own. You have to have a self-discipline. Nobody will go through. Please don't do this. You should have your own discipline. Second, related to teach, what is that they should do with the knowledge that they have gained in the class or MA become class or income class? What is that they do? How well do they in this? Opportunities are there. own, learn on your own. I will ask you a simple question, very simple question. How much time you spend in a day? करके नहीं अलावा वॉचिंग कुछ रीडिंग टेल मी आंसर
ये डेली पे तो लेकिन
ओके सर बड़े जी paper every day without fail.
Yes,
without fail.
Read newspaper and even I have published my letters have been published in Indian Express. A number of letters have been published. So I feel very happy whenever my letter is published in Indian Express. I also write some letters in Marathi papers and number of letters have been already published. So whenever I, you know, right, I feel very happy. Thank you, sir. I also read the Hindu regularly. Thank you, sir.
Others?
I am a regular writer for Hitwada, Careers and Lokmat.
Okay, good. How many of you read a new book once in 6 months?
Sir, I am passionate about the new books.
Okay. Only one response. How many of you go to library or on the web see a research journal once in 15 days?
I do not read newspaper daily, but I do that. I go to the library always. Very good, excellent.
You need not go to library, you need not buy. You can even see, all of you must be having a smartphone with you. Is there anybody in this group without a smartphone? Impossible, I think. The answer is impossible. Nobody, yeah, everybody will be having a smartphone. That is the biggest source for you. You can read newspapers, you can watch, you can read research journals, you can even read e-books. There are some books available on Google. You can download and this thing. You have a TED platform on YouTube. YouTube, I think all of you must be having access to YouTube for their entertainment. In addition to your entertainment, you can listen to nice talks, TED, T-E-D. I think all of you know TED.
Yes.
What is TED?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That is the biggest platform where we have the powerful speaker or expert people giving speech on different topics.
Technology. D for design. subject any day. About the presentation skills, about the soft skills, about the communication, non-verbal communication, visual communication. As you like. Keep learning. Keep learning. That is the most important thing. Others may please mute now. Please mute because somebody is complaining that the voice is breaking. Others, please mute your audio. Am I audible? Somebody was typing there on the...
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Okay. So, please read this slide. I will give you one full minute. Please read this slide. One minute is up. So top to bottom. Now I will go back. Go back. Be open and flexible in your thinking. Flexible to learn. Flexible to accept advice, suggestions. Think better so that you will learn better. There should not be any rigid activities now. I will learn only during this time. I will do this only during this time. There is nothing like fixed timings to learn, fixed times to do things. We have experienced sufficiently during the lockdown period. So let us be flexible even in our personal lives. Only thing is, yeah, you can draw a line to what extent, but be flexible in your thinking, for which you should always look for and respect diversity because it gives new perspectives. You should always think about other subjects also, other areas also. Don't say that I am a history guy. And I did my research in medieval history, so on, so thereby I will teach medieval history only. Don't expect that all 35 years you will teach medieval history. People will forget you. They call you as a history teacher, R.I. You will not be there in their minds. Your subject will be there. They don't remember your name also. When somebody like me ask them after 10 years, they will say, "Wo yaad nahi hai sir, wo kisi ne aake bataya us din history karke bolte." No, they should remember like Anita ji. Anita madam ko pucha to malum ho jata. Also, from new thinking, new project will come for you. For we meet and interact with diverse people. Kaisa hota hai? Outside your specialization, area of work are normal social circle. Have a good doctor friend, have a good psychology friend. teach, add this chemical, add this chemical, you will get this karke. If it a particular deficiency, this how this will work, how it will happen, how it occurs. You are not going to explain or going into the details, but you are giving the basics. From there, you get new ideas. So make it a point that you also meet and interact people. That's why I said, go and attend seminars, go and attend workshops, go and attend training programs. Not only your subject, any other subjects related to having some interdisciplinary approach. We are now talking about transdisciplinary. Huh? And new education policy says multidisciplinary universities. Courses should be offered multidisciplinary. Commerce students can also think of doing a course in science. A science student can also do a course in political science. Nobody will stop them. You cannot stop them. UGC opened the gates. They can learn anything. You know that? New education policy said very categorical.
Yes, sir. Now interdisciplinary research is coming in a boom, computer science with law.
Yes.
You can have that combination.
Any why?
Any combination? Yes, you can have. That's means,
You are right. Computer science, law. Computer science, commerce. Computer science, English. Computer science, what do you call, physics? Any combinations. Multidisciplinary. Students are having choice. The moment they get 100 to 120 credits, you have to give them undergraduate degree. You say that a physics student should do core courses, say 15 courses, 15 into 4, 60 credits you are giving. So next 60 credits, he will go out and do courses from online. He will not even come to the class. You will get the certificate from SWAYAM. You will get the certificate from NPTEL. You have to accept. That's what your ABC says. You will get some more guidelines on that. They are going to allow rather direct the institutions who are having NAC accreditation A and above. Initially, they said 3.25 and above. And a place in NIRF top 100 ranks. Those institutes will also offer courses online. Courses, not entire BA become BSc programs. Courses, say modern history, medieval history, ancient history, quantum physics. So a particular paper, cell biology, University of Hyderabad is good for biology, right? Cell biology can molecular biology. So they can offer these courses. Students from Mizoram can also take courses from Hyderabad University. Students from Kashmir can also take courses. Vice versa, students from Hyderabad University can take good courses in JNU. The students are having all the options. The only thing is, yes, they should clear that. They should learn on their own. It is fully online. They should learn and they should get those credits and submit those credits. You have to give them a degree. That's why read that second sentence. Read or attend talks on topics in diverse areas. Interdisciplinary analogies from one field to another are often the genesis of innovation. The innovation comes from the different combinations. For which you should read a lot. That is the basic thing that people should do, which many of the teachers stop learning. I have no hesitation to make this statement. Many teachers, they think that ek fara wo naukri mein join ho gaya na, mere ko sab malum hai. Malum hai. Ye kon hai bolne wala, hame ye sab malum hai. They stop learning. They think that students will not question. जो भी वो बोलता है उसी में क्वेश्चंस देंगे वो पास हो जाते हैं वो गया मेरे को. That's not the case. You have to update. if you are not going to be, you are not going to update, you will be replaced. I'm very carefully using the word. I'm not going to say you will be removed. You will be replaced. You will be replaced by technology. Aapko tanka mil jata. Nobody will remove you. Once you are regularized, because you are born in India, most blessed place. एक फिर नौकरी मिल गया और उसका रेगुलराइजेशन दो साल के बाद हो गया, 35 साल आप आराम से सैलरी ले सकते. बट यू विल बी रिप्लेस्ड, रिप्लेस्ड बाय टेक्नोलॉजी. डोंट अलाउ दैट टू हैपन इन यूर लाइफ. वी हैव सीन हाउ difficult it is during the pandemic situation without work, sitting at home. It's very painful thing. I think all of you will agree. Thereby you read a lot, broaden your horizons, meet and interact people, diverse people. For that you should respect always the diversity. Keep always open mind, flexible in your thinking, flexible in your thoughts, flexible in learning. That gives opportunity for you to learn more and be a lifelong learner. Then only you will stay relevant. People will appreciate. This is what I have written from my experience. Then the second one is emotional competency. Learning requires emotional support. You are there an agency to make the students to learn. Teachers will be called as mentors. You are no longer a teacher. You are an educator. You are a mentor. It doesn't matter what you teach. Already I told you. It matters how you teach. Students will remember how you teach. You should have that emotion when you go to the class. This is my class. These children are my children. It is my responsibility to see that they should learn everything that I am going to teach them today. If you are a science teacher, taking them to a lab and doing an experiment, see that every student understands what the experiment is and what they can do that experiment on their own. Don't go to the class with an excess baggage, thinking all other personal problems. I should have gone to hospital taking my mother. I should have gone to school to pay the school fee of my child. Sab chhod dijiye. Leave those things outside the college or outside the class. Just get into the trance. The moment you enter into the class, should forget all of that. Don't carry your mobile phone also. I have seen some people are responding calls in the classroom. Most awkward thing on the earth. Teachers responding on mobile phones. If you are responding, your students will also take the calls in the class. Then entire class takes the calls, you know how it chaotic it will be. You should not. No heavens will fall if you don't take the call for 60 minutes. अरे 10 साल के पहले ये फोन कहाँ था? चलो 10 साल के पहले, 15 साल के पहले फोन कहाँ था? They are only supplements, not the main organs. They are only supplements. ठीक है, you'll take the call later. You should get into the trance and dedicate. With complete emotion, yes, this is my responsibility. Have that grit. Then you will deliver a wonderful talk. You will get a nice feel that, yes, I have delivered a nice talk. This is what we were missing during the pandemic situation, teaching online. Had it been offline, I would have seen into your eyes and I could able to draw your conclusions. Aap sun rahe ya nahi, aapko kuch difficulty hai ya nahi? Are you pretending? I can see. I mean, when I look into your eyes, I can tell you that. But if you are really in problem, not able to understand, I will come and tell you. I will repeat that for you. I will help you to solve the problem. I will help you to write down. If you don't have a pen, I will give my pen. No issues. Give that support. Some students from rural areas, they may not be able to understand. Even if they understand, they have a shy to ask questions. You can see from their eyes. And go and talk to them. Call them by name. Make it a point. Calling them by name makes them more comfortable. And ask that, beta, are you able to understand? Can you understand? Is it clear? You may have 100 students. I'm not asking you to go to all 100 students. But look at the whole class now and then. That emotional support is required. Well, I was looking at some source from Swami Vivekananda lecture series. Somewhere I found this diagram. I don't know what is the meaning of this diagram. But there is a strong message below that. Very powerful message. Read out that for you. Efficiency and energy comes from emotion. Efficiency and energy comes from emotion, not from intellectual knowledge, not from your domain knowledge, which can only direct that emotional energy. Means, which can only direct for the class to take on, goes on. But the real impulse comes from emotion. It makes you work at your best. The real impulse of your teaching comes from the emotion that you carry to the class. It will make you to work at your best. You don't know how energetic you are, how efficient you are outside the class. But if you are inside, once you go into the class with that emotion, you will automatically become an efficient teacher. Automatically you get that energy to give a talk for 3 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours. No problem.
Sir, emotional means linkage is a very special linkage between the educator and student. It plays a very important role. It is beyond your whatever lecture you are delivering, the content you are delivering, it is beyond that.
Yes, that is what I was telling. It matters how you are teaching.
Yes. Because few students, they are the outsiders, they could not cope up with the new environment. They are very good in learning, no doubt, but they could not cope up with the new environment. So you need to, you know, I will like to share one example with this. A very good student from a rural area, she came down to Nagpur for pursuing her graduate degree. So she was excellent in learning, excellent grades, but after few days, 15 days, she stopped coming to the college. Then I asked that why she is not coming to the college. Then no one gives me satisfactory answer. So I just came to know that she is living in one hostel. So I went over there, I visit her room and I saw she was sick. होमसिकनेस तो था ही सर, लेकिन एक्चुअली वहां पर ब्रेकफास्ट वो स्किप कर देती थी, उसके बाद में वो डायरेक्ट लंच लेती थी, उसके वजह से वो कोप अप ही नहीं कर पाई. तो देन आई टुक मींस अदर एफर्ट्स, आई मेंटर हर एंड आई मेक हर कंफर्टेबल एंड देन बिकॉज ऑफ दैट शी इज now passed out of with wonderful grade. She is a wonderful personality and she remembers me ki ma'am agar aap us samay nahi hoti to main to chhod deti thi aur ghar jati thi. so that emotional support every student.
I suggest all the participants to give a big clap to madam. That's nice. That is, she will remember you throughout her life.
Yes, sir. I didn't understand at that moment what actually I was doing, but now she is pursuing her master's degree, and from that she called me and say, whatever I am today, ma'am, it is just because of you. मैं नहीं कर पाती, otherwise मैं तो ये कपड़ा छोड़ देती थी, मैं तो अपने गांव चली जाती थी. तो यू नेवर कम टू नो हाउ इनडायरेक्टली इमोशनल तुम आपका सपोर्ट जो है वो किसी को किस तरह से ट्रांसफॉर्म कर रहा है, ये आप नहीं जानते.
This is the reason why I said don't underestimate. You have accomplished something. You have all the qualities. You only should know how much you can do. Do it. That's it. Don't look this side, left or right. That's it. Wonderful.
Thank you. Thank you,
sir. Yes. Yes. Good. Dinesh is clapping for you.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
So this is what it makes all the difference. If you are emotionally charged, carry that emotion with your students in the class, and also same feeling with the institution, because it gave you an address, so and so, assistant professor, department of ABC, so and so college. So you have an address because of that institute. So you should also own the institute. Don't belittle your institute outside. Take pride and do best to improve the status of your institute also. This happens only when you are emotionally attached with your students, with your teaching, with your job, with your institute. You should develop that emotional competency and demonstrate that. You will automatically become an efficient teacher. That's it. This is not my words. Swami Vivekananda said long, long back. When I was reading, I thought it is apt and I copied here and showing it to you.
Sir,
yes,
sorry to interrupt. Hmm. One observation or one mind experience I would like to share at this particular point of time. In our earlier college, that is to say, presently I'm working in a Symbiosis Law School, Hyderabad. But earlier I used to work in Nagpur in Raisuni Law College, wherein we people were under an instruction that we need to impart our teaching only in English. That was a requirement, and because I was teaching in 5 years and 3 years both as a senior faculty, so I had an observation that few of these students who were belonging to Marathi medium, some of them were coming from rural areas, from UP and Bengal and some other places. So it was very difficult for them to understand in English. But because I was confined by the instruction which was given to me, what I did is I started my own YouTube channel, wherein I delivered all my lectures in English and in Hindi both, mixed language. So that the content should reach out to the student. May not be necessarily that my student would be subscribing it, but it would be a channel which is available to a student whosoever is interested to learn law. So it was a fantastic response which I found. And what I feel is, because I was confined a little bit because of the instruction which was given to me by the management, so that was actually coming as a hurdle in order to reach out my student with my teachings. So that was actually, I found myself to be like emotionally supportive to the student. Those who were having a little bit of hesitation asking the question in the class, those who were not that comfortable to ask a question with the peer groups. So now they got a resource from where they can get their concept clear. Anita madam is also available to them in both the three languages, English, Hindi, Marathi. And in between, I used this tricks actually. I speak a little bit Punjabi also, whatever sentence, even a single sentence, if I knew in a particular language, I try to speak that in that particular class so that whosoever belonging to that particular language would feel close to me, would feel comfortable with me while the teaching and learning process. So that is what I found, that using the small tricks, you can be with the students. You can come close to your students, and the very purpose of giving your teaching would be satisfied.
I will ask you to clone more Anitas.
Thank you, sir.
Cloning karke aap, I mean, that this is what we need. Please, I will talk about this. I mean, you are all going a little ahead of me. I have another two slides. I will tell about this particular exercise. What you have done is the most needed one now.
Thank you, sir.
Excellent, Anitaji. Excellent. Then this communication is again coming. It will not leave us. I know that. It is another competency. See, look at this. This was a quality, this was a skill, this is a competency also. Yes, communication is the ultimate. And they also need good interpersonal relations, such as listening, observing, speaking, questioning, analyzing, and evaluating. Teachers should have this good interpersonal relations. If you get any opportunity to undergo any kind of training on interpersonal relations, I always advise you to do that. IIM Ahmedabad conducts a 4-day training program, but it is very expensive. Now they are charging around 1.25 lakhs for 4 days. I don't expect teachers can spend that kind of money. But otherwise, if you can get any opportunity, it's a wonderful. Many institutions are doing, attend one such program. It will change your thinking, your style of handling students, handling situation, handling the classroom, or even your thinking will all be changed. Communication should be very clear, effective, and target-oriented. At this level, you should keep your audience in mind. Are they your first semester students? Law integrated means 17 plus, 18 plus students versus LLM class, 23 years old. There is a difference in their understanding, their maturity levels. Bilingual class, English medium class. You can keep this audience in mind. When you are a guest speaker in other institution, keep audience in mind. When you are giving a public talk, give a different kind of a content. Not the same content what you teach in the class. Content in the same, the standard of content, the style of content, the style of teaching, style of expression. I will not speak much on this. This is the most important one which I have. Technology competency is the ultimate. Ultimate, because it has become a part of our life. We were not having the language of social media, language of sharing, Paytm, ATM, XYZTM, Google Pay, share the location, transfer kar do, text karo. As soon as you reach home, text me. You are speaking these things at least 10 minutes a day. Am I right? Even more than that.
Yes, sir.
More than that.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Which was not the language 10 years back? It was not so in 2011. Ye sab baat nahi kiya. Now we are speaking about share karo, transfer karo, order karo, online pay order, Zomato, Swiggy, they all become, Amazon has become the household name. people are not going, are not stepping out. They order everything online and they get things done. Amazon is making tons of money. Teaching and research is also no exception. That is what my point. Like how you are using technology and the help of technology to make your personal life comfortable. You also use technology in your teaching and research. Make your classroom rich using ICT in the classroom. For which you should learn two important things. One is good knowledge about cloud computing, that is Google tools. What is Google Drive? What is OneDrive? Google Forms, Google Docs, Google Links, Google Advanced Search, Google Classroom, Google Scholar. Learn all these things thoroughly. Sunne ka nahi? Thoroughly. They must be conducting some classes on this also. If not, go out and learn something thoroughly, 100% Google tools, which is very, very essential. You will be a 50% online teacher. I mean, in some cases, you will be 100% also, because Google Classroom can be used as a good LMS. And this is not technology. Many teachers, they think that ए कंप्यूटर कहते हो टेक्नोलॉजी है हमारा है वेरी डिफिकल्ट इट्स नॉट डिफिकल्ट माय डियर फ्रेंड्स इट इज ओनली अ स्किल आर यू नॉट यूजिंग यूर मोबाइल फोन आर यू नॉट सेंडिंग मैसेजेस थ्रू व्हाट्सएप आर यू नॉट हैविंग वीडियो कॉल्स आर यू नॉट सेंडिंग मेल्स आर यू नॉट डूइंग SMS ये सब हो रहा है यू आर लर्निंग If not completely, at least bits and pieces. Same way you can also learn. And you cannot afford to pretend ignorance anymore. And don't say that we don't have good library. We don't get any journals in our library. Paise nahi, government is not giving any grants. Woh din chale gaye. Grants hints ke baad chale gaye. But you have e-journals available on the web. You only should know how to learn, how to access them. Have you heard the word called NDLI, National Digital Library of India?
Yes, sir. Kharagpur ka project hai.
No, only one person. Yeah, any other? Any other person who have registered,
yes, sir.
Who knows about NDLI? Saket, who?
Yes, sir. NDLI, National Digital Three. Library of
India. Rajshri. Only three. It is a nice web portal services offered by IIT Kharagpur, supported by Government of India. Each one of you can register and be a member in this with your college, details, you can get registered. Then you will get access to all those journals and e-books available on NDLI, one of the best portals that we have. And nobody should complain that, I mean, I don't have access to journals. I do not know how to do this. You have to learn these things. Go to your library, take the help of your librarian, he will tell you. And don't feel shy. You know, learning from a librarian, assistant librarian, unke paas kaise jana hai, kyun jana hai karke. Don't feel shy. They must be knowing. You can register on your. And don't think that you are the only source to create resources. There are already people who have created resources for you in your subject. You know, in your own law, there are tons of material is available. in your own subject English literature, in your own subject political science, in your own subject physics, tons of material is available in the form of OERs, called Open Educational Resources. Open Educational Resources. It is an ocean. You only should know how to search. How to search. Develop an ability to search the resources online. I think in this FIP, they must be having a session on OER. Somebody will be talking about it. Or go to Google and type OERs, Open Educational Resources. You will get a nice article on this. You can read and start practicing it. You can download video, you can download audio, you can download text material. Only thing you should know, which are all allowed, which are not allowed. There is a rule by Creative Commons. So CC by CC not. So you can find out what is what. Even Google has advanced search techniques. You can find. Don't ask me questions on this. That's not my area.
Preeti ma'am ne liya hai sir OER ke bare mein, CC Creative Commons ke bare mein.
Okay. If you are good with OERs, even if you are not in a position to take online class, even you are not in a position to reach out to your students, just give the link to the students. Aap jaake OERs mein kisi acche se material lejiye. Your Swayam is a OER, your NPTEL is a OER. Go to OERs and select one topic which is suitable, which is customized for your syllabus. Give that link to your students. That's it. That's also online teaching. Not necessarily you should teach like this. Live lectures is a luxury. You can teach offline also. Share the resources through WhatsApp, through Facebook, through email. Several forms of to share offline. And without your intervention, OERs also can be shared. That is also online education. Only thing is you are customizing to your syllabus, which is the right portion, select that portion or do some modification and share it with students. And finally, you can do your own MOOC courses. Somebody must have already taught you. Once you said OERs means MOOCs must have been covered. Or somebody will talk about this. Massive open online courses. You try to offer one course to your student next semester. Have an attempt. What Anita ji did is a wonderful exercise. Forget about MOOCs, OERs, all these things for a minute. I will use the new word called blended learning. Blended learning. You are blending both online as well as offline. Create all the resources, put them on the web. Those students who are not able to come to the class, they will listen to your lectures which are available there. Those people who are working, those people who are doing part-time jobs, those children who are coming from agriculture families, wo harvesting season mein nahi aa sakte, wo rainy season mein nahi aa sakte. They have to go and work in the agriculture fields. For them, once they come back, they can listen to your lectures. You may be having sports personnel, you may be having poor learners. They will listen to you second time, third time. That is the purpose of online education, not because of this lockdown period. Not for the sake of technology. It is for the sake of a larger perspective that a repeated learning is possible. Those who are missing your classes can access. And those students who are not offered, because I cannot pay the fee, but I can learn your things because you are available on public access, public domain. During this lockdown periods, you know, the whole world is open now. Top world-class institutions are also offering courses online free. Just to learn, that's it. I'm not taking any certificates nor any degrees from you. But for the sake of learning, I'll tell you one finest example. Like Stanford, MIT, Harvard, all started offering courses. Stanford University offered a course called Machine Learning online free. You know how many people have registered? More than 7 million. 7 million equal to 70 lakh people. More than that. One course called machine learning. Not that all the people will take the certificates. Teachers have registered, students have registered, research scholars have registered, professionals also have registered. So professional, what they do, they will learn it, they go back and they practice themselves. Research scholars, they for their research purpose. Students, if they want certificate, they have to pay $120 and take the exam and take the certificate. Fine. Teachers, they can learn and understand how to teach machine learning. What is machine learning? How to teach? They can understand and learn. Similarly, you can also create and provide resources. Let the students learn. Don't be under the impression, why should I share my knowledge? Yes, up there, the other, back, tomorrow nobody will come to you. Who said that? Tomorrow new generation will come and they take. It is not your own. Somebody taught you, you have learned. You are transferring the knowledge to the next generation. One of the basic qualities of a teacher. So you should not have that feel of sharing your videos, sharing your PPT, sharing your reading material. Do that. Then all of you will become the most preferred teachers. Like what our friend Anita Jay is doing. Bring that kind of a disruption. That's the word I want to use at the end. Disruption in your thoughts, disruption in your actions, disruption in your class. Don't teach 100% syllabus. I am the only source to teach class. You are not the only source. There are several sources. But you can bring some life into the class. Give them a topic, ask them to give a seminar. Give them marks, nothing to worry. Conduct some sudden quizzes. Allow them to learn, allow them to participate, allow them to debate. Change the style of teaching in one way. Actually, that's another topic where I have to think, give a talk on blended learning, but you can bring some disruption. Go to Google and type a word called disruptive technologies. Note down, disruptive technologies. There are about 7 to 8 technologies which are going to change the entire world in next year. The world will not be like this tomorrow. In 2031, you will not be able to see the world like this. I do not know. I will be able to ask you that same question, how you were 10 years back. But you can question, you can see yourself on that day. Try to be there as a relevant person. Be ready for tomorrow, not for today. Today, hoya. You should be ready for tomorrow. Then only people will appreciate you as a teacher, will respect you as a teacher. Stay relevant. Okay? Stay relevant. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Nothing worthwhile ever achieved without deep thought and hard work. Let there be a deep thought, good thoughts, noble thoughts, with adequate hard work, then you can achieve wonders. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
You are really a great teacher, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Any questions? Next 5 minutes. I think we have 5 minutes time to go.
Sir. Yes, participants. Now the you can ask questions if you want to ask questions to sir. Thank you so much, sir, for your excellent lecture. Very lucid and very interactive session. And I'm surprised to see so many like their personal experiences of teachers also they have shared with you. Thank you so much.
There are many people who are doing wonderful things in this community.
Yes, sir.
And the fortunate thing is we don't have any right platform for them to express themselves. HRDC is one such platform where we can always take out and bring out their talent. And if necessary or wherever possible, we will add something to their knowledge. We are not going to make them great teachers in 28 days or 30 days. We only give them some kind of an awareness how to make, and it is for them to take it. So thereby, we will see them after 2-3 years or after 5 years as great teachers. And I wish all of them to be great teachers, to be remembered by their students eternally. Thank you.
Dr. Narasimhulu, sir. Good afternoon. Yeah, sir. Thank you so much for sparing your valuable time with us. It was indeed an eye-opener lecture for all our participants. You actually talked about many qualities of the teacher in exhibited what you preached by, you know, being present 3 minutes before after the break. So there are so many intricacies. Also, you talked about how the teacher should stand in the lecture, in a classroom and all. It was indeed a great gain, value addition to our participants, and this lecture will be remembered for so many, you know, in our career, basically, for all of us. Also, you talked about critical thinking and so many other qualities also. So I once again, on behalf of all our participants, extend my sincere thanks to you. Dear participants, Dr. Narasimhulu sir is a very, very busy person, and he being director of one of the HRDC is very close to me. He is in fact on our advisory committee and has been, you know, giving suggestions to us many a times. Indeed, he is a great contribution to the HRDC scheme for the teachers as such. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. And thanks to
it was the a ladies pleasure to have you, sir.
Who are your pillars? Right. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
The illiterates of 21st century are those who do not learn, unlearn, and relearn. And students have consumer mindset, and the world is open to them. With this message, I thank you, Dr. Narasimhulu sir, for sharing your thought and vision on evolving role of teacher. Beautifully giving your lecture on evolving role of teachers. Thank you once again, sir. Sir, we'll be inviting you in our next FIPs also, sir.
Okay. That's can I sign off?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Good luck.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So participants, will have our next session at 2 o'clock. Now it is 1:14. So we'll be having our next session at 2 o'clock. So I'm ending the meeting, and we'll have our next session at 2 o'clock. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.